I can call my own. Here in your embrace, where your mercy overflows, it's here that all my doubts and fears just melt away.
Dear friends, indeed this is the day that the Lord hath made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm Reverend Stephen Mullings, Methodist minister assigned to the Lyndhurst circuit. Today I want to speak to you on the theme, God is our fortress. And as Psalm 18 verse 1 to 3 says, I love you, O Lord, my strength. The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer. My God, my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold. I call upon the Lord, who is worthy to be praised. So shall I be saved from my enemies. Well, the word fortress, according to the dictionary, means a stronghold or a fortified city or town. I would like to say from the very outset that for us as children of God, our fortification is not found in anything we can construct ourselves. Our fortification comes from God Almighty, His grace and His mercy. As a result, we can be assured that our fortification is certain and secure and is totally dependent on our commitment to God Almighty. God is our true source of strength, security, and salvation in this broken and sin-twisted world. But whatever you are going through now, whatever lies ahead, whatever difficulty is waiting around the corner, God is able to work in and through the circumstances. God is our refuge, God is our deliverer, God is our everything, and we can trust Him because He cares about us. Life right now might not be what we planned it to be, but we can hold on to the reality that the best is God is with us. No matter what the problem might be today, the Bible teaches us that even in the middle of turmoil and trouble, God is good. God is faithful, and we can always trust His love, His grace, His mercy, and His strength. King David wrote in Psalm 27, verse 1, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" Or perhaps it is easier to read this verse than to follow it in our daily lives. Because for several of us, instead of trusting in His protection, we get overly anxious. Instead of relying on God to be our fortress, we allow fear to grip us and we end up worrying about what we think we need to do instead of trusting in Almighty God. If we are honest, although we say that God's timing is always perfect, we find it so difficult to wait, don't we? Let us be reminded in the words of Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Sometimes we need to wait. Sometimes we need to pause for a while. And sometimes we need to spend time trusting God that He will move in our situation and circumstance and act in our best interests. We need to seek God in every situation and focus on His faithfulness and goodness in all things. King David had confidence in God, and so in the midst of terrible circumstances, his focus was always on God. God was his light, his salvation, and his fortress. David turned to God and lived his life secure in God's presence. David listened to God's voice, and so, because of his confidence in God, he was able to sing for joy with great excitement and enthusiasm. The wonderful news today is that God never changes. And so, in the same way God acted for David then, He can act for us today. The question that is relevant is, do you trust God in the same way David did back then? Do you believe that God can turn those perceived impossible moments of your life into great opportunities? And do you believe that He can turn your mourning into dancing? Today we can rejoice in words that are found in Genesis chapter 50, verse 20, which says, "But as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day, to save many people alive." Do you have the same confidence in God that King David had? Is your focus on God as your fortress, your refuge, and your strength? Isaiah said of God in chapter 26, verse 3 and 4, "You will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on you because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for in Yahweh the Lord is everlasting strength." Also, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 and 7 tells us, "Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus." At some stage in our life, we all will have to make a serious decision, either to focus on the problem or difficulty we are in, or to focus on God, who can deal with the problem and the difficulty. I trust we will all make the wise decision to show the world that as His children, we are confident in the fact that He is our fortress, our place of safety, and our deliverer. When King David focused on God, He saw no reason to be afraid. When we focus on God and think about what He has already done in our lives, we will be confident that our God is our faithful fortress. God has been with us in the good times, and I can assure you He will be with us in the not so good times. Like King David, we need to not only say with our lips, but also show in our lives that our God is all powerful, that He is the great I am, that He is the Alpha and the Omega, our rescuer, our deliverer, our savior. David fully trusted the Lord for his salvation, and we should fully trust him as well. He is the one who calmed the storm with his word, and because he is on our side, we have no reason to tremble or to be fearful. Because God is with us, we do not need to be afraid of the storm or the situation or circumstances that we are in today. We can have peace in the midst of the storm because we are safe, we are secure, we are fortified, all because God is with us. Hallelujah. Friends, when our life is continually focused on God, we will have confidence in His ability. We will have confidence in His mercy. We will have confidence in His grace. And we will certainly have confidence in the time of His blessing. We are spiritually fortified when God is in the center of our lives every day. Won't you keep God in the center of your life today? Draw close to Him and experience His perfect presence, His faithfulness, His power, and His love. Let us confidently commit ourselves to listen to His voice, listen to His directions, seek His will, seek His purpose, and rest secure in His loving arms now and forevermore. God bless you all. Amen. You are